Jan O. Jorgensen to serve, love all, play.
Nice, very nice. Well, Steve, when you and I were in Fuzhou just last month watching the China Premier Super Series and Jan O. Jorgensen winning the title there, beating the world and Olympic champion Chen Long in the final in two straight games, I think we made comment that it was probably the best we've ever seen Jan O. Jorgensen play. He really is in great form at the moment.
Yeah, he is. I have him as a favorite to win this match, even though he lost yesterday. They were already qualified, as you said, Jill. And
Three love.
When you know that you can play the same opponent the next day again, the match is always a little bit difficult because you know that you're going to play the day after anyway, so you might not go totally all out to win a match. And Jan has normally got a really good statistic against Chen Houwei, so given that and his good form from China Open and also Hong Kong Open where he reached the semifinal, so he followed up on it, is an indication that that he should have a good chance here.
Oh yes, that's very, very nice indeed. Well, there was thoughts, I'm sure, back home in Denmark, Steen, after the Olympics when Victor Axelsen got the bronze medal and he actually went ahead of Jan O. Jorgensen in the world rankings and so on, that maybe Jorgensen was very much the number two, but you can never take away from the fact, this is a good rally, isn't it, that he is the first European ever to win the Indonesian men's singles, which he did a couple of years ago. He's become the first European ever to win the China Super Series and the first Dane and European ever to end the year ranked number one on the Super Series standings.
Yeah, yeah, that's a really good achievement. It's been a good badminton year for Denmark. Of course, Jan, also part of the winning Thomas Cup team, the first ever European team to win Thomas Cup. I think for a number of the players on that team, it sort of defined their career. And Jan has been out saying it. I mean, even if I don't win a match more for the rest of my badminton career, I still have won the Thomas Cup.
Yeah.
So you could say that it's a monkey off the back for a number of the players.
Yes, well, anyone who doesn't really understand the significance of the Thomas Cup, it's the World Team Championships for men, in essence, playing for the Thomas Cup.
And Denmark has been in the final, I think, 9 or 10 times and lost all the times ahead of this summer or this May in Kunshan.
6-2.
And it's also it's funny because, I mean, why do you need to discuss who is the better of Jan and Victor? Why not be content that you have two really, really strong players on the top of the world who can sort of lead each other on together with Whittinghus and some of the upcoming younger players? It's very rarely they meet in the tournament, actually. It might happen here, but that would be a positive problem because then it would be in the final. So if they can get a good training relationship going,
3-7.
Everybody will benefit from it.
Yes. But that's the nature of sport. We always compare. So, I mean, of course we compare the top two Danish players.
Yeah.
And we compare, you know, the two greats over the last era, Lin Dan and Lee Chong Wei. It's the nature of sport. That's what competition is. We want to compare. But I agree with you wholeheartedly. It doesn't matter which is the best out of Jorgensen and Axelsen. What matters is that they're both up there at the top of world badminton and are challenging for the big titles.
Yes, and one thing that is special for badminton is that we practice as a team and compete as individuals.
Yeah.
And that makes it a little bit difficult because everybody has to understand that and acknowledge that to build a good training regime. Because if one player or a pair is sort of a little bit afraid of the national competition, there's a big, big risk that they will ruin the practice for everybody.
Yeah. Challenge here.
Yeah.
It's our first challenge of the day.
I thought,
and Houwei
just show something about my eyesight. I thought it was clearly in that one, but I think the linesman might have got it right.
Well, Hawkeye will tell us for sure, and it was out. Well done, line judge. Yeah.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 9-4. Play. Service over. 5-9.
I'm a little bit concerned about Tian Houwei. I've been concerned in the last couple of tournaments because whilst he's well worn a knee bandage on his left knee, as a sort of a precaution, I've seen it for over a year now, there's much heavier strapping underneath that bandage nowadays.
But
look at his movement there, that's fine.
Yeah, and he's in China Open, he had a strapping on his right knee as well, so that's at least
six,
come off.
Yeah.
Nine.
I thought he played beautiful at All England.
Yes.
I thought he really showed some promising skills there. Injured for the summer. He's got those deceptive shots that can spell problems for a number of players. Very good attack, precise attacking shot there.
Yeah.
So if he's back to some of that form from All England, then we're in for a really, really good match.
Well, the injury would explain some of his results over this past year, because he's been a big supporter of the Super Series. He's played all 12 tournaments. The All England final, as you mentioned, one semi-final, that was Indonesia. But he's had six first or second round losses as well.
Yeah, and that doesn't add up with the display we saw at the All England.
No.
So that's why we are a little bit uncertain on where do we actually have him.
Oh my goodness me! He missed it! Turn round, had another go and made contact. That's amazing.
8-9.
Misses it altogether. Okay, well, I'll play a backhand about 6 inches off the floor.
Yeah.
That's incredible, isn't it? And what fighting spirit!
And very alert from Chen Houwei as well.
Cold.
Because
service over. Fault. 10-8.
Yeah. Says it's above the waist.
And I'm pretty certain that what the umpires are looking at is the position of the non-serving arm, in this case the right arm of Chen Houwei, and he lifts it a little bit.
11-8 interval.
So it's a 3-point advantage for number one seed, Jan or Jorgensen.
Baghånd, det er over.
Så må jeg ikke blive bange for at løfte ham, fordi jeg løfter en.
Nej,
altså,
du skal huske, herfra, når du er her, så skal den højde på ned til baghænden. Den må du ikke bare spille flad ud over, hvis den står lige
springer,
foran dig.
Springer.
Ja, hvis han har spillet ind i baglinjen, ind fra baglinjen til det her område.
Sure.
20 seconds.
Just to remind you once again, #BadmintonDubai. follow us on Twitter, and if you have been, you'll know that the Olympic breaststroke champion, Adam Peaty, was here yesterday. That is, tried his hand at a bit of badminton.
Yeah, and he might have competed in this arena here.
I'm sure he did compete in this arena, because this, at times, is a swimming pool.
12-8.
2010 FINA World Swimming Championships were staged here, and the World Cup last year for swimming.
Excellent smash from Jan Jorgensen.
Now, is that some of the tactics that Kenneth Jonasson was talking about?
Probably. They didn't discuss it in the interval. It was more like the pushes, the flat pushes that Jan was to push and be ready for the next one. He shouldn't push the first one to win it, which is, in my opinion, very clever. Always keep your balance, be ready. You must expect your opponent can get a lot of shots back, otherwise they wouldn't be here. And then Jan made a comment that he still should be able to lift to Chen Houwei, even though he'd put one long. So that's about not being scared of that little drift that there is. But now he's lifting one more long.
Service over. 9-13.
One of the things I was a little bit concerned about ahead of this match was that it was so early in the day. I don't hope that Jan Jorgensen spent all the night up watching his girlfriend. She's a handball player in Denmark, played the semifinal of the European Championship last night. So I hope he's...
Did they win?
They didn't, unfortunately. Oh, Netherlands beat them to the finals.
13.
But I hope that Jan got enough sleep. He was...
I hope you weren't up all night watching the handball, were you?
Not at all. Not at all. She's in fact the captain of the team, so two
11,
very
13.
Strong sports persons. Oh, that's a good run of points for Chen Houwei, because he didn't have to work a whole lot for it.
Racket work, isn't it?
Service over.
We were talking yesterday about players who have that ability just to
14,
flick
12.
The racket head over the top of the shuttle and bring it down steeply. I think we were talking about Victor Axelsen, weren't we?
Yeah, we saw that when he had the quick release, then it spelled trouble for Li Chengwei when he was using his full power smashes with a lot of arm movement. It wasn't really a problem for Li Chengwei. He could actually counter-attack on Victor Axelsen in those situations.
Good use of the body smash.
15-12. Jim?
What was that? Something about lifting maybe deep into the forehand corner, I'm not sure.
Service over. 13-15.
Delightful. Yeah. That is delightful. when you're moving back in court, as Tian Houwei was on that occasion, 15. To control the racket head for the round the head straight drop. That is great skill. So back to within a point again. Oh, and then an error on serve.
Service over.
What a waste, all the hard work.
16,
from Tian Houwei.
14.
Yeah, and he's so close now, Tian Houwei, that he has a chance of stealing this game. I feel that Yan has been in control of most of the rallies, even though he's in defense. I felt that he's had control of the rallies, and here, when he reached 13 in the game, a lot of strange mistakes where he's not in a position where...
15, 16.
I think perhaps he underestimates Tian Houwei a little bit.
Yeah.
I know it sounds strange when he lost to him yesterday.
Yeah, it was one of the early morning matches, wasn't it? We weren't actually here for it. I'm wondering, although obviously we don't know, which end of the court that's Jan O. Jorgensen started yesterday. Because that little bit of drift does make a little bit of difference. And when you've got players that are so evenly matched, that little bit of difference can make the difference in the outcome.
Yeah.
16, I read a 17.
Report of the match, and it said that there were quite a number of mistakes.
From Jorgensen.
Throughout the match, but yeah, especially from Jorgensen, who ended up losing it.
Oh, there's another mistake, and it means that Tian Houwei is back level. 17-all.
And it's terrible mistakes because, I mean, what's the threat for Tian Houwei here? There's no threat. So it's a wrong choice. I mean, he's simply going too much for it. He's not ready for that shot. He feels that the second attack at the net, the push at
18,
the net, that it's enough.
17.
But Tian Houwei gets it back.
Yeah. And the reaction of Tian Houwei after the rally, it was a sign of big relief.
Yeah.
He knew he was lucky to get away with that.
Yeah, he hasn't played particularly well in this first game, in my opinion, but he's in great shape to take it.
Two-point 19, advantage and 2 points 17. Away from this opening game. And when you consider he was 4-9 down at one stage and 13-8 down. Good net shot. Of course, it's the short lift, but the defense of Tian Houwei is beginning to frustrate the Dane on a run of five straight points. Tian Houwei
20,
now has three game point opportunities.
17. Clear.
In.
Serving in. Six straight points.
First game,
close out the opening game.
21-17.
21-17 confirms the umpire.
Just
under 20 minutes of play.
Well,
one still wondering how that happened.
Yeah. Just caught a word from Jan Jorgensen when he changed the side. What's going on, man?
Ja, det er lidt ligesom, at du vil gerne skabe pointen, i stedet for at vente til, at det kommer naturligt, så vil du gerne få pointen over på din side ret hurtigt. Det vil sige, at du prøver også at slå nogen altså direkte ned på stik, og så videre, derfor du ryger dig med i nettet. Du prøver at stoppe bolden helt ud, i stedet for bare at lave stopbolden, og så kommer det naturligt. Det bliver lidt, det føles lidt...
Ja.
Tilbage til den oprindelige plan.
Det
er spille. Nej.
Bare
lade
en
chance,
eller to.
I stedet
for at spille her kort
en dag, jeg er udskilt. Jeg har knyttet på kroppen. Jeg har lige nakket, så kom det udskilt. Ja. Jeg er ikke skarp nok. Nej. Men det er tilbage til tegnebrættet, ikke? Det vil sige, at skal maskeringen på, så trykket, så kommer det ind over hovedet på dig især. Ikke? Altså, det er meget ærgerligt, at jeg har fået den her, men altså, du kan sagtens vinde de næste to. Tak, det er vi enige om.
No fucking problem.
Ja, godt. Okay?
Kom nu, mand.
Yeah, he is a little frustrated with himself. Come on, man. Final words.
Yeah, and...
Thank you.
He said, I can win the next two. I definitely have a good chance of winning the next two, and Kenneth said also, you can win the next two. So they feel it's back to the drawing board, and I think Kenneth, he summed it up really, really good in one sentence, and he says, you want the points too quickly. You want them on your side too quickly, the points. You go too much for it. Just play. Stick to the plan.
That's tremendous accuracy. Lovely.
Service over. One all.
Well, to get himself out of trouble because taking it so late in the forehand corner. Overdone it.
Yeah. Service over.
And that's the typical.
That's the typical for Jan Jorgensen since like 13 in the first game. Overdone it. That sums it up.
Oh, it's just wide.
Yeah, and again he goes for almost a winner in that defensive shot. And it quickly turns out to be a loser instead.
It's over. G1. 2-4.
Challenge.
Well, I thought that was in, Steen.
Tian Houwei challenges.
I think it might have gone wide as well.
We'll have to have our cup of tea on this one.
And Jorgensen broke his string, so he's cutting his racket at the moment. I didn't see him break the string, though, so he might have cut his racket.
In frustration.
His frustration.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, you owe me a cup of tea.
Yeah.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 3-4. Play. Service over.
Just quick movement around the head. Quick racket work as well from Tian Houwei.
5-3.
I remember when he really burst onto the world stage, which I'd never seen him play in the semi-final of the Australian Grand Prix, as it was then.
2013
beat Li Chongwei, didn't he? 3 games. All of a sudden, everybody was saying, who is this young new left-handed Chinese player? Is this the man that's going to take over from Lin Dan? He hasn't really fulfilled the potential that and the excitement that we all felt when he achieved that result 3 years ago.
Service over.
I thought he was on his way in Birmingham. Really thought he played well there.
At the All England earlier this year, yeah.
Well played. Last two rallies has seen Jano Jorgensen back to the winning ways from the first part of the first game.
Service over.
All right.
7-6.
The rally was in progress. I saw somebody behind the court with a flashlight camera. I hope that didn't distract Jorgensen.
Center.
Yeah, there's still a red flashlight on the other side of the court. It's a red flash, so it's not like it's blinding him or anything.
No.
It's just a distraction in the background that's annoying.
Good judgment.
Service over. 7-7.
Yeah. Very good judgment.
8-7.
Good shot.
My word, that's good.
Service over. 8-8.
Leapt from the base position in the center of the court to play that smash.
Service fault called.
Service fault called.
Service
again.
Over. Tian.
Second time.
Shuttle, please.
That service judge, Dathan from India.
9-8.
Scored a fault on Tian Houwei.
Shot.
Yeah.
Very good variation
service
from those.
From
that forehand corner. Very difficult to
Nine
see
all.
Whether it's straight or cross. And I think if Chen Houwei gets that left knee ready.
Well, yeah. We just changed. Jano Jorgensen is pointing to this person with the with the red
no
light
flash
on the camera.
And Chen Houwei thought he wanted to change the shuttle.
Yeah.
Change. Yes.
And he was.
Thank you. Where? The dots.
Could almost shout to the spectator with the flashlight. Turn it off.
Yeah.
Service over. 10-9.
It's a good return of serve, wasn't it?
Well played. Well played. There's a lot more bite in his smashes right now. General Wei.
I think ever since he was faulted in this second game on his serve, he's just up the intensity, up the pace. As if to, he's using his anger and frustration at being called a fault and using it to good advantage. Indeed, it is the left-handed number three seed, Tian Houwei, who has the advantage at mid-game interval. It's a solitary point. The lead is a lead.
Sørg for at være hurtig på din anden forhold, uden at rykke. Altså, når han spiller der til, så skal du være, prøve at være hurtig. Ja. Det.
Ja, fordi han spiller mig bare væk.
Ja, ellers.
Altså, det er jo også det. Jeg
har lidt svært ved den der forhold til at styre imod. More urging him to be patient or different advice?
I'm not really sure what they were discussing. It was a continuation of the conversation. We got in the middle of the conversation and something about reducing the pace in the shots, which is difficult. I have a feeling Jan is fired up. He feels he has a good chance of winning, and maybe that's what's preventing him from being calm enough. And I think it's going to be realistic. Yeah, right now, Chen Houwei is in the driver's seat. He's got one game, and it's all square in the second. So. It's about crunch time now.
12-11. Yes.
well played. And that was what Kenneth was asking for. The first push is merely a push to get a better chance.
13,
this one,
11.
And he's ready for the next. Good shot. I would challenge that one if I were
14,
Chen Houwei.
11.
Oh, he's only got one challenge left in this second game,
yeah.
And I think he's probably feels I've got to keep hold of that in case it's vital later on. Oh, yeah,
yeah,
I would have challenged
yeah,
that.
Probably, yeah. But he was on the other side of the court.
Yeah.
So difficult for him.
Yeah. Clever.
Service over.
Half-pace body smash.
12-14.
He's got some nice changes of pace, Chen Houwei, and I feel that if he gets in a little bit better physical condition in terms of injuries and so on, and can do that more often, then he's going to get even more dangerous. Good spot by the umpire there.
Wide. 6 of the last 7 points.
Yeah.
16.
And now Yan is standing in a good position on the front court. He's standing quite close to the net, pushing Chen Houwei to the back court. And he can do that because he's quite fast backwards. And that's what's helping him as well in Indonesia Open, where he often does well. There's a lot of drift there. And Yan, he can afford to stand close to the net. Good smash.
Service over. 13-16. Short.
Yeah. Got what it deserved.
Service over.
Do you put that down as good disguise from Jorgensen, or do you blame
18,
Tian Houwei
13.
For backing off? I think backing off.
Yeah. He probably had to back off in order to cover his long backhand, where Yan has pushed him flat a
yeah.
number of times. So the service return wasn't as good as he could have hoped for. The
14,
Chinese player. This
18,
one was good, though. Efficient with 2 smashes in a row.
Oh,
service over.
Huge leap in the air. Going for the
19,
acute angle.
14.
And finds the net. As he does with the return of serve, and I guess that previous one that you were
20,
talking about not putting enough
points,
pressure on the return of serve
14.
Contributed to that error.
So service fault
oh,
called.
Goodness,
yes.
Service fault called.
Yeah.
Service
that's
over.
Racket not pointing in a downwards direction.
Yes.
I have to say I don't agree with that
no,
call.
Do I.
But very often I would agree on the short services, but I think Yan was really deliberate here because he knew he was going to flick.
Yeah.
15-20.
challenge.
Jan or Jorgensen challenges called out.
His first challenge of the match. Jorgensen. Well, whether it's in or out, I think it's giving him a chance to just calm down, because I think he was a little bit riled by that service fault called. What does Hawkeye say?
It's long.
Yeah.
Challenge. It was a break of rhythm.
Unsuccessful.
And as you say, Joe, to calm down.
16-20, lay.
That looked a nervous shot to me.
Yeah, I don't think it's nerves. I think it's losing the composure.
Yes.
I mean,
you're right.
Why are you arguing so much with the referee after you've been called for a service fault? We haven't seen anyone say, okay, you're right. I'll change it. There were no service fault.
Yeah.
That has never happened.
No.
So just play on. Now he's 18, wasted 20, three more points on it. And it's in jeopardy of losing this match in two games.
Yeah.
So it's
yeah, you can tell he's uptight. I mean, that last error, tension in the arm.
This is a chess game. Who will first make a poor quality shot?
Oh, my goodness.
Challenge.
Oh, challenge here from Tian Houwei. I thought it caught the line.
This is one of the situations where I'm so glad we have the Hawkeye, because it's really difficult to get it correct. But we've had good linesmen this week.
Very good linesmen. Yeah. Well, if it is in, it's game over. And we're into a third and deciding game. Oh my goodness.
Challenge unsuccessful.
No, challenge successful.
Yeah. And that would have cost Chen Houwei the game. Had we not had Hawkeye.
Yeah, exactly.
19-20.
So five game point opportunities.
Ooh, what a bad serve.
That's a terrible serve.
And he's annoyed with himself, Chen Houwei.
21-19, though, second and game. We will be treated to a third and deciding game. 23 minutes into the match, and it's one game all.
Stikkende, det er kun for at komme højt på forbanen, det er ikke for at...
Jeg går all in på løbet.
Og du løber også all in på at løbe. Altså hvis den kommer, så er det naturligt for dig.
Ja.
Så vi skal have overfyldet med. Også, det vil sige, vi skal også have power smash.
Ja,
meget
mere.
Kom igen,
hvis jeg helt lige starter lige.
Oh,
20 seconds.
Up to the minute news of all that's happening. Follow us on hashtag Badminton Dubai.
Final game. Love all.
2-1 game play. All. And the number one seed, Jan or Jorgensen, scraping through that second game, having looked as if he was in control at 2014. Oh, my goodness. Just look how much the left-hander has been made to twist and turn. Deep forehand, backhand, then back to the forehand again. That's, I like that from Jorgensen, really making his opponent work.
Yeah. The Danes, they clearly got the plan cut out. The question is, can Jorgensen carry it out? And Kenneth said to him, get a hold of yourself in there. Stay focused. You want to create points too quickly sometimes. Just play and play and play and play on again, and then the opportunity will occur by itself. And it's not like Jan is injured or tired or anything. He's got excess energy. I think actually excess energy is a problem. He feels that this is a great chance for him to reach the Super Series finals. And the way he's been playing the last month, must feel that it's a great chance of taking the title as well.
But
you can't think of that now. You got to think of this match.
Service over.
Yes, always the advice to athletes, stay in the moment. The moment of now, don't think back to the past and supposing I played that shot and what have I done that? Don't live in the future. No. You know, I could win this tournament. You've got to stay in the moment.
There was a Danish handball coach, male handball coach, he said, get out of the emotional slavery. And I actually remembered that when Jan was feeling a little bit sorry for himself about that service fault call there. That's emotional slavery that you can't get rid of your emotions there. They stay with you for too many minutes.
Hold. Service over. 3-5.
Jorgensen needs to stay patient, but I don't think he mustn't go passive.
No, and it's a little bit easier for Chen Houwei on this side of the court to create his own opportunities, because he can push Jorgensen to the back. Doesn't have to care about the drift.
Yeah, like that one.
Exactly.
5-4.
Against the drift, those tend to stay in.
So he should have a better chance of opening up the Danes' defense. And also, it's difficult for Jan to be accurate on the baseline of Chen Houwei.
Four straight points to go into the lead.
6-5.
I think one of the advisors from Xia Xuanzi, the Chinese coach, is that Chen Houwei must try to intercept in these flat plays.
Well, that was extraordinary. Both players said they wanted to change the shuttle, didn't they?
I wasn't sure.
This time the players are allowed to change it. He'd hit that
service
lift,
over.
Tian Houwei, that was going to go long.
Six, Jorgensen. Seven.
Oh, that looked strange from Chen Houwei. Almost a miss hit.
Seven.
It was most peculiar. What on earth happened? Did he just completely miss timing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it came off the frame, didn't it?
Ooh, two easy mistakes.
Seven.
Yeah.
Allows Jorgensen to take the lead here. It's interesting, it's on soft-paced shots below the tape. Change of pace,
yes,
sudden change of pace, because that surprises Jorgensen.
Eight
here,
all.
This one.
And follows up quickly.
Yes,
quick movement.
And again,
yeah.
Quick movement backwards with an attacking shot. And he's got a lethal attack from his forehand side, Chen Houwei. And over and over again, we get examples on what Kenneth Jonasson said to Jan.
Eight.
Don't go for the winners, just play on and they will occur. If you go too much for them, you will make mistakes.
Punish the short clear.
Service over. Nine.
Oh. Just watch where Jorgensen's feet are as he plays this. Yeah. Nowhere near the back of the court.
Good shot.
Service over.
Excellent placement. Goes more and more into the body of Jorgensen. He
isn't
able to get away. Loose serve again from Chen Houwei.
Service
He's not
over.
Comfortable on that low serve.
10-all.
Yeah, that was his downfall on game point in the second game, wasn't it? Fabulous rally. Wonderful.
11-10.
And it means that the number one seed, Jan or Jorgensen, has the narrowest of possible advantages at the change of ends here in the third and deciding game. Just 5 minutes shy of the hour mark.
Det handler om, at når du ligger op, så er du klar med din catch, for han kommer nedad på dig. Okay? At du hele tiden er fokus på, hvad er det næste slag, hvad er det, der sker. At du ikke spekulerer på, at ah, jeg skal lige prøve at slå den her nedad, eller jeg kan lige tillade mig at gøre det her. Du skal være på derinde hele tiden. Det handler om, at du er her. Okay? Og du vil det her mere, end han gør. Ja, du tør det. Okay?
Ja,
det er
but that seems short and sweet from Jorgensen. He's having something to eat, right? Keep up the energy levels. What did Kenneth say?
Yeah, it was in all talks about being in the moment. Stay there. Don't get clever with some smart ideas of shots or anything. Just stick to what we know is working. Jan is playing on the side now where he can push a little
11,
bit more.
10.
He should have a great chance of taking this, but we must say that both players have been a little bit inconsistent, so everything is totally open here.
Yeah.
Service over. 11 all.
Oh, there's a challenge.
Tian Houwei challenges called in.
It was a good deception, but he's wondering whether he was leaving it Tian Houwei or he was tricked by it.
No, it's crucial, isn't it? Here we go. Oh, it's out.
Correction,
yeah.
Out. 12-11, play.
Oh!
Yeah.
Did you think that was wide?
13-11.
But if I were Yan, I would move one step closer to the service line because Tian Houwei is struggling on his low serve and he's been called every time he's flicked, tried to flick. Maybe not every time, but two times at least.
Oh, that was a better serve, wasn't it? And about another error on the return.
14-11.
Since the mid-game interval, going to the left-handed Tian Houwei.
And the last three errors within the first two shots.
Yeah. Another error. Well, you said that it was erratic and therefore it was still wide open as to which of these two players would win.
Yeah. Erratic and inconsistent, but the reason that it is that erratic and inconsistent is that it's a very fine line that you've got to hit tactical-wise, and that goes for both players. If they are a little bit off that line, the other player will capitalize. So it's because it's so difficult. You've got to be so, so disciplined and have the correct accuracy on your shots.
Service over. 16-11.
How many
12.
Errors on the return of serve or within the first four shots of the rally since the change of ends?
At least three.
Yeah.
Terrible serve again.
Service over. 13-17.
I simply think that all four players left in these semifinals, they feel that it's a very, very good chance of being the champion of the BWF Super Series finals, because Chen Long is out of the tournament, Li Chengwei is out of the tournament. So those two players, they've taken a number of the major tournaments up for grabs, and it's a good opportunity.
Yeah.
To good saves there by Jorgensen, but kept his composure. Chen Houwei only 3 points away
18,
from
13.
Booking a place in the final.
He's moving quickly, isn't he, Tian Houwei?
Yeah.
Yeah, all credit to him.
And that's promising for him if he can get rid of that
19,
nagging knee
14.
Injury. If he can get his overall speed up, then he could be one of the players to look out for in 2017.
Yeah. Yes. Match points have arrived. 10 of the last 12 points since the change of ends.
20, match point 13.
What a second half of the deciding game. And that's lovely from Jorgensen, congratulating his opponent. And Jorgensen may well look back and rue missed chances.
19, 21,
but this man, the left-hander, took his chance and took it so well. 21-17, 19-21, 21-13 in the deciding game in an hour and 2 minutes. Oh, they're going to change shirts. That's lovely. Lovely moment for the two players. It shows the meaning of this Super Series finals tournament. And it's a match I'm sure that both of them will remember for a long, long time. For very different reasons, of course. So, Tian Houwei, the left-handed number 3 seed, through to the final of the Super Series finals.